Blackstone presents Unlawful Justice by Vish Dhamija. This book is read by Neil Shah. To all my friends who have never read any of my books. Justice. You get justice in the next world. In this one, you have the law. William Geddes. Part 1. 6 June. A worthless person, a wicked man, is the one who walks with a perverse mouth, who winks with his eyes, who signals with his feet, who points with his fingers, who with perversity in his heart continually devises evil. Proverbs chapter 6, verses 12 through 15. 1. He shouldn't have been there. Maheep Singh shouldn't have been where he was that fateful afternoon. But he was. He was 19, spoilt rotten by his parents, particularly his doting mother, Jaya. Not that his father, Maninder Singh, ever really, truly endeavored to stop his wife from indulging the male heir, born after 3 daughters. Daughters were supposed to be reined in, their freedoms curtailed. But a son should be exempt from any and all discipline, Maninder Singh believed. The immunity from his parents, coupled with the unaccounted wealth, accumulated from equally unmentionable sources by his father, though envied by his friends, made him like the allegedly impermeable Titanic racing towards the iceberg. He tried smoking at 13. He smoked sporadically for the next few years. However, he became a regular smoker at 16, occasionally with cannabis when his friends could stealthily procure it from insalubrious sources. He started drinking spirits at 16. His dad had occasionally allowed him a sip or two from his own drink at parties earlier, but that was enough for him to start liking it. He spent the night of his 17th birthday with a prostitute. His money fetched him friends who loved his money more than they loved him. These supposed friends had hired a hooker as his birthday gift. Anyone with a little sense and experience who had been watching him all along could predict that Maheep would disgrace himself and his family if he continued along the same path. He could only escape till his luck held out. Anyone with a reasonable IQ could foretell that his luck was about to run out on him, like it ran out on Napoleon at the Battle of Waterloo. Just as Napoleon should not have been anywhere near Waterloo in Belgium when he was, Maheep Singh should not have been anywhere near Defence Colony in New Delhi when he was. Maybe it was not the same quantum of bad luck, but it was similar. Simply put, sometimes people are in the wrong place at the wrong time. That is pure kismet. Even if they have no sinful intent when they start from wherever, they get reckless or greedy, or fail to control themselves when something is too tempting to resist. Sometimes, the brain is too phased to compute the consequences. At other times, it is too confident to fret. And if someone is intoxicated, it makes the whole slippery slope a whole lot more lubricious. Sadly, for people like Maheep, the end is never elegant. Maheep Singh was tall and bulky for his age, and looked considerably older than 18. The usual suspects, drinking, smoking, drugs, fast food, and virtually no physical exercise, had dutifully colluded to do their bits. He would look far better if he shaved his jowls and lost the excess weight, but he couldn't care less. He had just finished school that summer, on his 18th birthday in April, a little over a month before it all happened. His board results were expected by the middle of June, which would decide which college or colleges he got admission into. Although his father was influential enough to pull strings or bust bollocks to get him admission into a few colleges, Maheep still had to obtain a respectable score. Maheep wasn't too concerned about which subjects or course he would pursue. He had made up his mind long ago to follow in his father's enormous footsteps, sail the heretofore charted waters, and make money. A lot more of it than his father had acquired. The means, however dubious, didn't disturb him. His father, Maninder Singh, tall and bulky like his prodigal son, was essentially a bagman behind the facade of a proclaimed businessman. He worked for corrupt politicians and criminals, collecting and distributing their money, illicitly earned through bribes and criminal enterprises. Hafta, hookers, hawala, hooch. Nothing more than a pimp laundering dirty money. The commissions were a small percent, but the turnover was high. Someone had once run some complicated algorithm in the 80s and surmised that 25% of all money printed by the Reserve Bank of India.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.